Your first alert with meteorologist Max Lagano. 7 News Sunrise with John Bridges.
Next, what former President Trump said as he gets back on the campaign trail out west.
Plus, a social media post has many schools around the country on edge. While any threat locally has been eliminated, authorities speak out on what they're doing to keep students and staff safe.
Well, we actually have a few showers moving through our area late this evening. We'll have a closer look at where they are and if we may see any tomorrow.
Sponsored by Lake Charles Memorial Health System. Covering the news for Southwest Louisiana. This is 7 News Nightcast.
Former President Donald Trump was back on the campaign trail in California yesterday and spoke to the press during his first press conference since the presidential debate. Good evening, I'm Morgan Babineaux. Washington News Bureau correspondent Stetson Miller tells us more about his stop in the Golden State.
On Friday, former President Trump vowed to launch large deportations of immigrants from Ohio and also defended a far-right political activist who's been seen alongside him this week.
Speaking before members of the press at his golf course at Ranchos Palos Verdes, California on Friday, former President Trump relied on familiar campaign trail talking points like illegal immigration, false claims of rising crime, high cost of living, and he went after his opponent. But he also defended the far-right activist, Laura Loomer, who's been repeatedly seen with Trump this week, and comes after some raised concerns about her past controversial remarks.
Laura's been a supporter of mine, just like a lot of people are supporters, and she's been a supporter of mine. She speaks very positively of the campaign. I don't control Laura. Laura has to say what she wants. She's a free spirit.
He also vowed to launch large deportations from the city of Springfield, Ohio. This comes after debunked claims of Haitian migrants eating pets there circulated throughout the country this week.
We will do large deportations from Springfield, Ohio. Large deportations. We're going to get these people out.
In Washington, I'm Stetson Miller.
And closer to home, students in Jeff Davis Parish will see an increased police presence in schools this coming week. Earlier today, a social media post made its rounds about a possible shooting at a Jennings school, according to Jeff Davis Parish Sheriff Kyle Mears. Mears said detectives quickly determined there was no actual threat. The post was sent nationwide and was not specific to our parish or schools, he said. To be on the safe side, Mears said sheriff's deputies will be sent out to schools around the parish this coming week. Jeff Davis Superintendent John Hall reassures the public that his top priority is the safety of students and staff. Tonight is the last time you'll see us on 7 News from this temporary set here in the KPLC newsroom. After 4 long years of bringing you news from this desk, we'll be moving into our new studio tomorrow. Hurricane Laura sent our tower crashing into the building we've called home since 1954. After years of makeshift setups, cramped quarters, and loud noises, construction on the new building is nearing completion. Our producers, anchors, directors, and engineers have spent countless hours getting ready for the switch, and we're excited to show you the results of our team's hard work. Be sure to watch our first show tomorrow at 5 p.m. on KPLC.
Time now for your first alert weather forecast.
And we definitely are very excited about that. But in the meantime, as we talked about just a couple minutes ago, yes, there are actually a couple showers moving across parts of Southwest Louisiana this evening. The reason has to do with a very weak front swinging down from the north, but no, that's not going to bring any sort of cooler weather tonight. Instead, we just have a couple showers, even a couple spotty thunderstorms that have popped up, mainly across portions of Beauregard Parish, ranging from near Maryville down to Singer, and even farther off to the south and east, just near the Ragley vicinity, and even near Reeves into Allen Parish near Kinder as well. And some of that activity could continue to slide south, so if you do hear a rumble of thunder or even see some raindrops on your car window or maybe hear them on the roof, don't be too surprised tonight. So for that reason, we have bumped up the chances of rain definitely a little bit over the next couple of hours between now and say 3, 4 a.m. Even then, though, not everybody will receive rain, and those showers, I think, will remain on the spotty side. So a quick look outside otherwise shows a quiet picture in Jennings with still warm weather at 82 degrees. And as far as tomorrow goes, yes, there is still a chance we could see a couple spotty showers around. Otherwise, we continue with the warm weather, and that's not going to change into the week ahead. We'll have more on that in a few minutes. Morgan?
Thanks, Max. The South Coast Book Festival continued today at the Lake Charles Event Center. Festival attendees got to participate in presentations from award-winning authors, book discussions led by local writers, book signings, and workshops. Tamika Simeon tells 7 News what the South Coast Book Fest is all about.
It's an opportunity for us to promote literacy and lifelong learning. It's an opportunity for us to get the community and families excited about reading and literacy.
The South Coast Book Fest wrapped up today with a live poetry reading. The Midnight Fantasies Car and Truck Club held a car show today at Heritage Square in Sulphur. The car show is benefiting Lake Charles Pit Bull Rescue, an organization dedicated to rescuing and rehoming pit bulls. In addition to all the cars and bikes on display, guests were able to enjoy music, food, and browse products from a variety of vendors.
We're really excited to see everybody come out and support us today. It is always very humbling to see the public love what we do so much. You know, we've been doing rescue for 15 years now, and this is one of our favorite fundraisers we do.
To donate to Lake Charles Pit Bull Rescue, you can visit our website at kplctv.com. The community was invited to the Lake Charles Senior Center today for a craft fair. A variety of crafts were on display for people to purchase, including ceramics, crochet, and baked goods. An employee of the Senior Center tells us why it's important to support local artists.
I think that our artists should have an opportunity to showcase what they do to help them. You know, that some of them, that's their livelihood. So I think that it would be important for everybody in Lake Charles to support what our community puts out there.
And the staff at the Lake Charles Senior Center would like to thank everyone who came out today. Still to come on 7 News Nightcast, it's important to reduce the risk of suicide before it occurs. Find out what one group is doing to make a difference next.
7 News is sponsored by Lake Charles Memorial Health System. Your health care is personal.
Tacos.
Can Billy come out to play?
Yes!
Woohoo! The 2024 Tacoma. Toyota. Let's go places.
If you break a tooth or have a dental emergency, don't wait in pain. Call Oak Park Dental, and we'll get you in the same day to put the smile back on your face.
Saving money is now more important than ever for seniors. But if you purchased a $995 guaranteed acceptance plan, you could easily find yourself overpaying for very little life insurance coverage. With the $995 rate, a 65-year-old male receives less than $900 in coverage. For $10,000 in coverage, he would pay over $110 a month with a 2-year waiting period. Fortunately, with Senior Life Insurance Company, he pays less than $58 a month for $10,000 in protection. There's no waiting period, no medical exam, and he saves over $600 a year by choosing Senior Life. A 65-year-old female saves over $400 a year. Don't overpay for your life insurance. Call now to see how much money you could save with Senior Life. We could help you get cash back from your current overpriced policy. Call now to lock in your coverage and low monthly rate. For your free quote, call now.
Rethink how you get breaking news.
Local News Live, always streaming on KPLCTV.com and 7 News app.
Conversations surrounding suicide are sometimes considered taboo, but since 2004, the Out of the Darkness movement has been bringing these conversations to the light. KPLC's Stephanie Obadiku has more.
Statistics show that you or someone you know have struggled with suicidal thoughts.
Since September is Suicide Prevention Month, it's important to keep this conversation going so that people don't feel the need to keep it inside anymore.
We want everyone to know that there are risk factors and warning signs associated with suicide, and there's things we can do to intervene to help keep someone safe.
Megan Goldbeck is a longtime supporter of the cause, and she shares some signs that people can look out for.
Someone might joke about suicide or say they're feeling very overwhelmed, desperate, changes in behavior, new unhealthy behaviors, sleeping too much, not enough.
The Out of the Darkness Walk has gone on for years, and every year they raise money to help local causes in Southwest Louisiana.
When we're talking about suicide and suicide prevention, we usually talk about the number of deaths by suicide, but for every one person who dies by suicide, research shows that approximately 25 attempt, and for adolescents, that's much higher.
So far, they're a little over halfway to their goal, and we'll have more information on how you can donate on our website, kplctv.com. In Lake Charles, Stephanie Obidiku, 7 News.
Still ahead on 7 News Nightcast, as cases of mpox continue to rise in Africa and other countries with high risk factors, should we get vaccinated here in the U.S.? The latest recommendation from health officials after the break.
If you've been injured in a wreck or on the job in Southwest Louisiana, call your local hometown attorneys at Gordon McKernan Injury Attorneys. Get Gordon and get it done.
Luxury meets affordability at New Look Furniture. Why compromise quality or price? At New Look Furniture, we bring you the best of both worlds. Experience luxury without breaking the bank. Living rooms, bedrooms, dining rooms, mattresses, recliners, and lift chairs, all on sale. Worried about financing? Don't be. We've got you covered. And the best part, no waiting for days or weeks. You can have it delivered in just a few hours.
New Look Furniture, we save you money.
Named one of the world's greatest places by Time Magazine, Montgomery Whitewater brings mountain adventure to the heart of Montgomery, Alabama. One of only three man-made whitewater parks in the country, adventure may be found on land or on our Olympic standard whitewater channel system. Make memories outdoors. Learn more at montgomerywhitewater.com.
Meet Clean Boss, the most powerful botanical disinfectant and cleaner in the world. No harsh chemicals and safe around people and pets. Clean Boss kills COVID-19 virus, cold and flu virus, and RSV. Go to shopcleanboss.com now.
If you live in rural America and want better high-speed internet at home, say hello to the new HughesNet.
Hi!
Now I can video conference with confidence.
Yes!
The new HughesNet is Jupiter-powered, with unlimited data and faster speeds than ever before.
Now I can stream up anything I can dream up.
Now you can do it all. Connect, stream, and play. Call today to get free professional installation and exclusive offers. Call 1-800-704-8635.
Local News Live, always streaming on KPLCTV.com and 7 News app.
The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention say mpox vaccine boosters aren't needed in the U.S. as questions emerge around waning immunity. The CDC says the overall risk of mpox to the United States remains low. They recommend getting vaccinated if you've been exposed to the virus, among other high-risk factors. However, a new non-peer-reviewed study suggests immunity can wane within a year of vaccination. And due to this, there are questions around whether some people might need booster doses to maintain, quote, robust levels of protective immunity. Yesterday, Boar's Head said it will close the Virginia plant that produced deli meat products tied to a deadly listeria outbreak. The move is one of several changes Boar's Head made after what it called a dark moment in its history. It will permanently discontinue sales of liverwurst after an investigation found its production process was the root cause of the listeria contamination. A USDA report found insects, mold, blood on the floor, and a, quote, rancid smell in the cooler. Let's check back in with Max now for another look at the forecast.
Yeah, and Morgan, it was a hot day with temperatures into the low 90s across southwest Louisiana. We're going to talk about if we get that warm again tomorrow with the possibility of a few showers around after the break.
At Open Air MRI, we make advanced imaging easy and comfortable. Our state-of-the-art high-field open MRI offers advanced imaging without sacrificing image quality for larger patients, people who are claustrophobic, pediatrics, or people just anxious about the process. We offer the area's only truly open MRI. You can choose where to get your MRI, so ask your doctor about open air MRI, where advanced imaging meets exceptional care.
To get the settlement you deserve, you should have a lawyer with a reputation for taking companies to trial and beating them. At Paget McCall, we have that reputation with our passion and our heart. If you've been injured, choose your lawyer carefully.
Don't have time for a trampoline injury.
We don't have time for this today.
We're here with online check-in, so you can wait from anywhere. Plus, on-site digital x-rays. If you don't have time to be hurt, feel better faster with Family Physicians Urgent Care. Don't have time for a stomach virus?
I don't have time to be sick today.
When you're sick after hours or weekends, you don't have time to wait around. Save time and money and feel better faster with Family Physicians Urgent Care.
Get a lot more for way less with Optimum Internet.
Did you know with Optimum, you get internet for as little as $40 a month? Start saving today. Make the switch now and get a $200 prepaid MasterCard on us. Plus, get Max included for 1 year at no extra cost. Hurry, don't miss out on Optimum Internet starting at only $40 a month. Now, with equipment included. If you know, you know. Call 866-9-OPTIMUM or visit Optimum.com.
Sarah, you've got this, okay? But they lost.
Not really. Not where it counts.
The First Alert SkyCam Network is sponsored by Navarre Auto Group. Navarre has it. The First Alert Personal Forecast is sponsored by Home Building Materials, Lakeside Bank, Home Furniture, and Oak Park Dental. Weather with meteorologist Max Lagano.
Well, once again, a very good Saturday night here in southwest Louisiana, but like what we saw last night, it's a warm and definitely a humid one outside. We have a temperature over in DeQuincy at 81 degrees. Check out the dew point, though. That's up to 76 degrees, so that humidity is something no doubt you've been feeling if you've been outdoors pretty much at any point today. But here's the rest of our temperatures right now. They range anywhere from near 80 degrees, 80 in Jennings, to the low 80s elsewhere. That includes 81 DeQuincy and 83, the warm spot over in Cameron. As we talked about before, because of a very weak frontal boundary coming down from the north, we have a few showers out there basically right now across portions of Beauregard Parish and beginning to enter southern Allen Parish and northern Jeff Davis as well. We could see a few of these showers continue to move off to the south and perhaps eventually into Calcasieu Parish within the next couple hours or so. With that being said, rain is definitely pretty isolated or spotty in nature so far this evening, so I don't think everybody sees a shower tonight. But because we do have a few of those that have popped up, I have increased rain chances a little bit over the next several hours or so, just to account for the possibility of seeing a few of those spotty showers continue to persist throughout the next few hours. So let's take a look at that on Futurecast. Unfortunately, models have not really handled the idea of a few of those showers being around right now the best. And this is even with me playing around with some of the data a little bit. It's still kind of not really showing those showers as well as it otherwise could. But nevertheless, again, I am going to leave a few of those rain chances for a few showers in place throughout the overnight hours. And even into tomorrow morning, it would not be a shock for a couple spotty showers to kind of be around southwest Louisiana. You can see the model here tries to show that idea, but just east of southwest Louisiana. But note that very well could end up being directly over our area. Nevertheless, though, I think the biggest story tomorrow is going to remain the fact that it's going to shape up to be another warm day, especially as we head into the later part of the day. We may see, again, a couple showers around early on and maybe even into the early afternoon as well. But by the later part of the day, I think we start to see more sunshine. And if we do see that happen, I think we'll be right back into the mid to upper 80s, maybe near 90 degrees by the afternoon. So I would just implore you to keep an eye to the sky for the odd chance of seeing an isolated shower or two throughout the day. Overall, the warm weather is going to remain, though, the biggest story both tomorrow and into the upcoming week. A look at the large-scale weather map shows, again, that very weak front swinging down from the north. No, it's not really going to bring much in the way of cooler weather unless you do end up seeing a couple of those showers tomorrow. This overall pattern sticks around for Monday, but by the middle part of the week, as that front begins to weaken, we may see some more drier air filter into place, and for that reason, rain chances may go down a little bit more. Let's take a quick look at the tropics quickly now, and here's some good news for the rest of our area. There are no threats to Southwest Louisiana. We're just watching basically a wave off the Carolinas, but that's likely to move into the Carolinas, and Tropical Storm Gordon will remain far out in the Atlantic Ocean. So that's the good news for us. We have no tropical worries in the 10-day forecast. Instead, we are going to leave some low-end rain chances in play at least through Tuesday, but then those reduced from the forecast by the middle of the week. And Morgan, no matter which day you pick out there, it's going to stay pretty warm.
I know, we got a little taste of the cool, and now we're just back where we started.
Yeah, that was kind of fake fall. Real fall will come in time. You just gotta wait.
Oh, I'll try to be patient, Max. Thank you so much. Well, coming up, the McNeese Cowboys were in action for their first conference game of the season. We'll have highlights for you next in sports.
Your First Alert Wake Up Weather is sponsored by Merchants and Farmers Bank. Your future begins with our history.
Don't be afraid to show it. At Robinson Dental, preventative care, restoration, implants, and cosmetic treatments are all within reach. We specialize in gentle dental at Robinson Dental. You've got that smile.
Brandon Ollie here. Windows, doors, hardy plank, and vinyl siding. ReliefWindows.com.
This is the most powerful Tacoma ever.
Shut the front
with
door!
The shut the front door handle. Also known as the
Seriously Rob
handle. Or the whoa handle. And even the No Me Gusta handle. Standard on the 2024 Toyota Tacoma.
NetCredit is here to say yes to a personal loan or line of credit, even when other lenders won't. Apply online in minutes and get funds deposited the next business day or sooner. Go to netcredit.com. NetCredit. Credit to the people.
The Louisiana Food and Wine Festival, September 19th through 22nd in Lake Charles, with tastings from over 40 restaurants and more than 300 varieties of wines, beers, and spirits. Save $10 with KPLC10 promo code.
What if you went to your secret hiding place and found this? All drug use comes with risk. Before those risks become real, know that you can quit. For help with drug use, call 1-800-662-HELP for free and confidential information and treatment referral. Or go to samhsa.gov/knowtherisks.
KPLC wants to make you a winner. Visit the contest page at kplctv.com for all our current contests and contest rules. There are lots of ways to win. Good luck. Now, 7 Sports with Justin Margolius. Local first. Sponsored by Robinson Dental Group.
Tonight, a critical night for the McNeese Cowboys as they were looking to kick off conference play at home with a win. Cowboys taking on Stephen F. Austin. This is their conference opener, first quarter of the game. The Lumberjackets marching down the field, but not for long here. It's Jarrell Wimbley who gets the handoff, moves up the field, and it's stripped out by a swarm of Cowboys. It looks like we're having some technical difficulties on the highlights right now, though. The McNeese Cowboys just got an interception, actually, in the closing seconds of this game. A back-and-forth second half between these two teams. Touchdowns and Clifton McDowell had a big second half for the Cowboys, scored a touchdown at the end of the fourth quarter here to give the Cowboys a 28-24 lead. It sounds like the Cowboys just got an interception at the end of this game, giving them what looks to be a win, as you can see the highlights coming on here. But the Cowboys look like they're going to hold on with a 28-24 win over Stephen F. Austin. And now the Cowboys will move ahead to prepare for their matchup against Alcorn State at home next week. This is a team in the Gary Goff era that the Cowboys have yet to beat. They will have a chance to end that losing streak this next Saturday. We'll head out to South Carolina now. The LSU Tigers taking on the Gamecocks in their SEC opener. LSU went down 17-0 early in this one, but here comes the Bayou Bengals. It's Garrett Nussmeier who finds Kyron Lacy, a little play action to get within a score. Second half action now. Tigers looking to take their first lead. Mason Taylor slips across the middle of the end zone. It's Nussmeier who finds him for the 2-yard pitch and catch touchdown. Gives LSU a 29-24 lead. That's their first lead of the game. Just over a minute left to go. Tigers need a score here. They're down again. Josh Williams, he comes through for the Tigers. A couple yards out with the game sealing touchdown. LSU wins in a nail biter on the road over South Carolina late by a score of 36-33. And LSU coming off that dramatic win now looks ahead to a home matchup against the UCLA Bruins. Kickoff for that game is this coming Saturday, but it has yet to be announced on what time that game will be played. We had five local prep football games moved to today due to weather. So tonight we have like a mini touchdown live set for you tonight with plenty of great action. We'll start tonight's prep coverage with LCCP hosting the Bar Buccaneers, and it's the Trailblazers who get on the board first. A methodical drive ended by this touchdown run by Aiden Carter. That's a nice one right there to give LCCP the lead. Later in the first half, the Bar Buccaneers come back. It's Jalandon Gray outside the pocket. Look at this throw right here. Threads the needle to the end zone to Landon Kirkland for the touchdown as Barb snags the lead. And what a game this was. It stayed tight throughout, and it's Barb who gets the 34-28 win over the Trailblazers. Out to the swamp now. LaGrange hosting Westlake to the first half of this one. Rams on the move. Brody Anderson drops back, and if you've heard this one before, it's happening again. But Kevin Radu for the touchdown. The Rams extend their lead to 14 over the Gators. Later in the half, Rams continue to find success on offense. Anderson hands the ball off to Braylon Garrick, and he pushes himself into the end zone. It's another Westlake touchdown, as this one was all Rams throughout the evening. They get the 56-14 win. To Washington Marion, some charging Indians football as they took on South Beauregard. The Knights got things going early in the game. They jump out to a 25-point lead over the Indians. But the second half saw Washington Marion find some life as they put together some touchdown drives as Ashton Savoy takes the direct snap right here, and he takes this one to the house to cut the deficit just to a couple of scores. In the end, though, it's South Beauregard who gets the win 38-14. And we'll have two other games take place this evening. St. Louis traveled on the road to play Bunky, and it was the Panthers who won this game 55-10. One thing of note, though, for the Saints in the game is that kicker Zach Sanguini Truitt hit a 59-yard field goal. That, in fact, ties a Louisiana State record. And then the other game of the evening, Grand Lake taking on Rose Pine, and it was Grand Lake who controlled that game from start to finish, beating the Eagles 27-0. And that's it for sports. Morgan.
All right, thanks, Justin. With her pinkish cheeks and natural charisma, two-month-old pygmy hippo Mu Ding is making millions of fans online and drawing huge crowds to the Thai zoo where she lives. The pint-sized new arrival to the zoo in Thailand has been a social media hit ever since her keepers started uploading snippets of her life online. When she's not gobbling up grapes, she's rolling on the floor or taking a dip under Thailand's scorching sun. Visits to the zoo have been up by at least 30%, according to the zoo's director, One particularly popular video of her posted on Facebook has garnered 5.8 million views and counting. Now, Max, have you seen Mooding yet?
Yes, I have, and I can tell you that she is very cute. Our weather forecast tonight is not as cute as her, but it's not bad either, with temperatures into the 70s as we wake up tomorrow morning. We'll leave some rain chances in play the next few days, but I think those go down even more as we head into the middle of the week. Morgan?
All right, thanks, Max. And again, this will be the last time we say thank you for watching us in our old makeshift studio. It's a bittersweet day considering this spot is where I got my start, but I hope you're as excited as we are for the transition. Don't forget to tune in tomorrow at 5 for our new studio debut. Have a great night.
Get your news, weather, and sports on the go. Download the KPLC mobile apps today. Sponsored by Go Auto Insurance, low-cost car insurance. Closed captioning for 7 News is sponsored by New Look Furniture. We save you money.
I'm sorry.